back to the crazy train of frauditing, where we expose the real reasons why frauditards go out and film others and harass them, hiding behind the First Amendment. I want to thank you all for waiting so patiently for this video to come out that I talked about last week, but I had to wait for some more information to come in to make sure that we are 100% correct before exposing this liar, cheat, scammer, and all-around fraud. So go on out into your kitchen or pantry, get yourself some popcorn and pop it up, sit back and relax, because we're about to board the crazy train of frauditing. All aboard! Okay, ladies and gentlemen, today's video is going to take us to College Station, Texas, where we're going to expose the liar, cheat, scammer, and all-around frauditard known as First Responders Audits, Mr. Jesse Phillip Alba. Now, he's a small channel, not real big. He's only got 100. He only has 563 subscribers and 23 videos up on his channel at the moment. You may know him from our old friend, Half Blind Audits, Mr. Christopher Cowles. Now, those two are friends, and they've done some videos together. As being a major, as a matter of fact, we took down Half Blind Audits earlier this year due to being a major, major religious fraud. Now, First Responders Audits, Mr. Jesse Alba, still has a couple of videos up on his page that he did with Christopher Cowles, as you can see here. Now, that should pretty much tell you all you need to know about First Responders Audits, Jesse Phillip Alba. Two frauds hanging out together. You know what? But oh boy, does it get even better, folks. Ladies and gentlemen, our old friend Pat Fettick, he's the one that put me on to First Responders Audits, and the fact that he's running around telling people that he's a United States Marine, or he was a Marine for 13 years. Now listen to this a few times on his videos were found, where he makes that claim.
So you're young, you're starting.
Yeah. Yeah, you definitely
young. I was in the Marine Corps for 13 years.
I appreciate your service.
Hey, no problem.
Appreciate that.
Yes, sir.
You know, that's one thing I thought about. I actually thought about going to Marines, and for some reason I didn't do it. I don't know why.
Yes, sir.
I kind of wish I'd have done something, you know, along those lines.
He was.
Just in case, make sure they don't violate your rights.
They ain't violating nothing.
Just in case, sir. That's what we're here for.
You're wasting your time, sir. We are all veterans here.
I'm a veteran too, sir. United States Marines. How long have you been a police officer?
13 years.
Oh, that's wow. That's how long I did in the Marine Corps. 13 years. Yes, sir.
Appreciate it.
You know, I'm a U.S. Marine. I fought to keep you in this country. I fought to keep you in this country.
So I did a background check on the Service Members Civil Relief Act website using both of the dates of birth that Jesse Alba uses. And I did it from the time he was 18 years old, and I did it for every 2 years up until 2023. And guess what? There is absolutely no record whatsoever that Jesse Phillip Alba ever served in the U.S. Marines. So that's going to make me a little curious, and also I have to admit it made me angry that he would make such a claim, because I'm a United States veteran. And so Pathetic and I, we've been looking into his background for this fraud-a-tard for the past couple of weeks. Put out a little notice a few days ago, that we were doing an exposure video that you all were really going to be interested in hearing about, and this is it. So a very serious deep dive is what we did on this guy. And do you know what we found? Oh, yeah, folks. Jesse Phillip Alba of College Station, Texas, is a fucking liar and a career criminal who did 3 years in prison in Texas when he was younger. Remember this picture right here, Jesse? Yeah, your mugshot from TDCJ back in 1993? Yeah, when you started your 9-year prison sentence for 4 counts of burglary of a habitation? So that right there would disqualify you from ever becoming a U.S. Marine, wouldn't it, Jesse? Yeah, it's about time you start telling the truth, Jesse. You know, stop lying about this fantasy military service that you did. You didn't do a fucking day. All right, folks, I have to apologize. I'm starting to get a little uppity again because of what he's doing. So let's talk about First Responder Audit's criminal history, since we now know that he's a liar and there was no way he ever served a single day in the U.S. Marines. Yeah, Jesse has 6 vehicle and traffic charges, for such things as back in August of 1999. Let's see, he would have been 18 years old at that time. He was charged with driving while his license was suspended. That was out of Dallas, Texas. I have no other information before that that shows why his driver's license was suspended. But he was found guilty of that charge. He was given 30 days in jail and 12 months of probation. Now we skip ahead 4 years. And in December of 2003, he was charged with no liability insurance and having window tint on his vehicle. That was out of Kaufman County, Texas. He was guilty, and he paid a prepaid fine. But there was nothing listed on the teletype how much that fine was. Then we skip ahead a couple of years. July of 2005, he was charged again with driving while license invalid out of Kaufman County, Texas. He was found guilty and given a $533 fine and court costs charge. Now we skip ahead 5 years to June of 2010. Jesse's charged with driving with license invalid or invoked with previous conviction for that charge. And that was out of Fort Bend County, Texas. He was actually, the crime occurred on 6/16/2010. He wasn't charged until July 27th. But he was found guilty, given a $461 fine. And then we skip ahead 10 years to his next vehicle and traffic charge. He was charged in March of 2020 with improper driver's license for the type of vehicle, which was actually a reduction in charge from another driving while his license was suspended or revoked charge. After failing to appear for the charges in court for several months, which we'll see later on in his criminal history, he was found guilty and given a $266 fine. And then we look ahead. Jesse has 12 criminal charges that we should discuss right here. Going back to June of 1989, he was charged with theft. I believe it was under $200, which was a misdemeanor out of Dallas County, Texas. And that charge was dismissed. Then we go ahead a couple of years, April 1991. He was charged with burglary of a habitation, which was a felony out of Dallas County, Texas. He was found guilty and given 5 years probation. And then in May of 1991, he had two charges of burglary of a habitation out of Dallas County, Texas. He was found guilty on the two charges. He was sentenced to 10 years in state prison, but he was given the chance to participate in a boot camp program, which he did go to. That's the only boot camp he's ever gone to. He didn't go to boot camp in the Marines because that's a fallacy. So anyways, he did that program, the boot camp program. He was successfully completed that. And then, just over a year later, he picked up another charge. In August of 1992, he was charged with burglary of a habitation out of Dallas County, Texas. He was found guilty 3 months later, and he was sentenced to 9 years in the Texas State Prison. Out there in Texas, it's called TDCJ, Texas Department of Criminal Justice. And then you go ahead a couple of months, he was found guilty on another charge of burglary of a habitation. The crime actually happened in August of 1982, as you see. He's found guilty in November. He was sentenced to 9 years in state prison. And he started that prison term in February of 1993. He actually served 3 years of that prison sentence, as you can see right here. And then he spent the last 6 years on parole. And he actually, surprisingly, he didn't get in trouble for any of these other charges. Then we go ahead, and in January 1998, he was charged with violating a protective order. He wasn't charged until a month later, actually, but that order was vacated later in the year, and there's nothing that says what he got for violating that order. And then we go ahead 7 years till October of 2005. He was charged with theft between $50 and $1,500. Now, I'm not sure if that's a felony or not, but anyways, that was out of Dallas County, Texas. The crime occurred in October 2005. He was not charged until March of 2006. Hey, Jesse, you know, being a good Christian and ex-Marine that he claims to be, he fled to the state of Louisiana until he was arrested 3 years later in July of 2008. Now, when he was brought back to Texas for those charges, the DA dismissed him. Isn't that fantastic, ladies and gentlemen? So the 7-24-08, that's when he got the final extradition of St. Tammany Parish, Louisiana. And then in August of 2012, there's a listing on there for waiver of extradition, and then the number's 50764. I'm not sure if that's a case number or not. And then it says theft, Louisiana, and that was out of Fort Bend County, Texas. I'm not sure if he had a charge in Louisiana that he was supposed to go and answer or what happened, but I'm not sure. There's absolutely nothing listed after that on the teletype. Exactly what it says is August 9th, 2012, waiver of extradition, the case number, I think it's a case number anyways, and then it says theft, Louisiana. So, and that's it. So I have absolutely no clue. And then we skip ahead 8 years to November of 2020. And it says here he was charged with failure to appear, and that was for that vehicle and traffic infraction back there that I was telling you about. And that was out of Brazos County, Texas. Anyways, he wasn't charged until April of 2021 for that. He was found guilty and given a hefty $752 fine for that. And then we skip ahead 4 years, and he was charged with interference with public duties out of Brazos County, Texas, as you can see right here. So our young man is actually facing some more charges. Now, this fine, upstanding citizen that we're talking about here, Jesse Phillip Alba, he's got 8 civil cases that we should talk about, such as in October of 1994, while he was in prison, Michelle Hoka Alba decided to divorce him. Out of Dallas County, Texas, she filed that, but for some reason it didn't go through. I'm not quite sure why. Then we skip ahead 3 years. He must have ended up divorced at some point because he married a woman named Michelle Lee Alba, and she filed for divorce from him in 1997 out of Dallas County, Texas. That was not granted. Now we skip ahead a couple of months. He was given a civil protection order. There's no person listed on this civil protection order. There's the number for it right there. I can't find a person's name on it, but it was granted. And we skip ahead a couple of more years, and Elsa Martinez Alba filed for divorce with children. Yeah, I guess they had a couple. That was out of Dallas County, Texas. And that got dismissed due to lack of prosecution. So I'm going to guess that Elsa decided not to show up into court. Because 10 years later, Elsa Renee Martinez Alba filed for divorce again. Only this time she did it in St. Tammany Parish, Louisiana, where they were living together. And then you skip ahead a couple of years, Elsa Renee Terranova, she filed a civil action on behalf of their child with a petition to establish parent-child relationship out of Bell County, Texas. In other words, she was filing to prove that he was the father. Now, we skip ahead 6 years to September of 2017. Joan Cabell, filed to evict Jesse Alba. Yeah, but that got dismissed because Joan failed to appear in court. And then we've got June of 2020, Soko at Tower Point, which is where Jesse Alba was living at the time in Brazos County, Texas. They sued him for $5,033, which was awarded to the plaintiff, which was Soko at Tower Point. And that was out of College Station, Texas. So apparently, Jesse wasn't paying his rent for, I'm going to say, several months if it got all the way up to $5,000. So anyways, that's what happened there. So not only is Jesse Alba a major liar about being a U.S. Marine, and of course he forgot to tell anyone about his major criminal past and his prison time, Jesse Alba is also a fraud and a cheat in his business life. See, Jesse seems to have owned 2 or 3 construction businesses or that type of businesses. And he's received multiple complaints for taking money and not doing the work, or doing part of the work and never coming back to finish it. Here are some of those complaints right here. Here's a complaint right here on his current business called First Responders Construction. As you can see right here, this complaint says, hired to do some insurance work like rebuild fence at a back patio and re-roof home. Gave him half down, $21,000, and worked off and on about a month. Never was all supplies dropped, then just stopped showing up. Only about 15% of the work was done. And here we have another one right here. This one is called Deborah McIver, Jesse P. Alba, doing business as Debo Fencing and Remodeling in Slidell, Louisiana, has moved to Garland, Texas, is fraudulently presenting himself as a remodeling contractor. The allegation, acting as a home improvement contractor without being registered. Deborah McIver goes on to say he practices fraud and uses Facebook to advertise. Beware of this false contractor. Jesse P. Alba deliberately practiced deception as a contractor in construction in order to secure unlawful gain. Jesse P. Alba, DBA, U.S. Coastal Construction, and we also can prove that that is also J&A Coastal Construction. Now we go down to Mike Bartholomew. Mike says, we were scammed by this piece of work named Jesse Take Your Money and Run Alba back in 2013 in Katy, Texas. And then somebody named Sean Takedon says, hi Deborah, just got scammed by this guy Jesse Alba for $2,500 down payment for a roof job. Any tips on how to get money back from him? Thanks. Donna Dolan says, well, I wish I had seen this before I hired him. He demolished my kitchen and took drawers and drawers off site to stain. Now I can't get them back. He says they're not dry. Said bring them back anyways. Doesn't respond. Looks like I'll have to purchase. And then I didn't click on see more. And then Deborah McIver comes back again. She says, Jesse P. Alba, DBA, Debo Fencing and Remodeling out of Slidell, Louisiana, has moved to Garland, Texas, is fraudulently representing himself as a remodeling contractor. Here's a long-winded one from Tasha L. If you want to pay Mr. Alba and his crew to damage your home and property, and refuse to stand behind his work or replace what is damaged with your man, then this is your man, I should say. I could write an essay, but to be concise, hire Mr. Alba to do tile in a bathroom and a few other handy man items as a referral from a floor specialist at Home Depot. Nothing, I repeat, nothing was done properly, and the cost to dig out will be more than what I paid him. So anyways, what I was looking for was to even have one person to answer my requests that I sent out to several people. And I had one person finally reply, and she told me that Jesse Alba told her that he was a U.S. Marine, and he also told her he was a Christian, and that when he was soliciting the work from her. And then Jesse Phillip Alba ripped her off. This woman has 100% positively ID'd Jesse Alba, as you can see from her Facebook messages to me right here. So all I have to say at this point is, all 563 members of his channel, is this what you would want to support? Really? Is this liar, cheat, scammer, and criminal the person you want to throw your weight behind? To the members of his channel, are you willing to compromise your morals and standards to support someone who lies repeatedly about being a Marine, who does not divulge a significant criminal record to you, and who lies and cheats in his business dealings with people? Or are you, his subscribers, willing to stand up and shut him down? Are you willing to make him stop lying about being a U.S. Marine? Are you willing to make him responsible and to admit to his criminal past? Are you willing to stand up to him and make him stop stealing and scamming and cheating people in his business dealings? I ask you to stop supporting such a fraud and unsubscribe from his channel. Make First Responders Audits Jesse Phillip Alba even more insignificant than he already is by unsubscribing from his channel and shutting him down. Hello, I have been asked by a couple, three different subscribers now to use closed captioning on my videos because they are hard of hearing. Now, these subscribers would like to continue to enjoy the videos that are published on this channel. So if you have any knowledge on how to do closed captioning on videos, please send me an email so I can do this. I would love to accommodate our subscribers who are hard of hearing. And thank you very much if you're able to help me out with that. So thank you everyone for coming to watch this video. It truly has been an honor to debunk this fraud in his alleged military service. Not only that, but to let you all know about his criminal history and everything else. Now, if you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button and let me know. If you're not subscribed to the channel, please do so now so you will see all of the great content coming out in the near future. And please consider telling your friends, coworkers, family members, your enemies, all about this channel and how we expose the truth about these frauditors. All of us here now would greatly appreciate you helping the channel to grow, of course. And that's all we have for now, folks. I hope you enjoyed this major exposure, and I hope to see you very soon for the next exposure we're going to do. And until then, y'all take care now.